Ladies and gentlemen, what is going on? My name is Nathan Laurie, and today I'm going to be flying a cargo plane in GTA 5. And before I do this video, I just want to apologize for this shit that you're seeing on the screen. In case you didn't know, obviously you would know, it's fucking obvious. I am recording on my iPhone. There's nothing I can do about this. I will eventually get a capture card and some software to edit this properly on, but until then, this will have to make do. I'm going to be finding this in first person as well, so let's get on with the video. As none of you would actually know, because I've never told anyone this, I've never told anyone on my chance since I had my channel this, I've actually flown a plane before. It wasn't like a proper big plane, it was a Cessna 152. It's like the Mammothus that you can find over on that part of the airport. And again, I apologise for those lines. They're not very visible, because I'm going to be doing, this in first person. I'm going to be showing you guys how to like fly a plane properly, how a pilot would carry out his flight and stuff like this, how he would prepare for takeoff, things like this. So give me 1 second. I'm going to be taking off runway 30 left, but before I do this, the pilot would do checks. So first of all, he needs to check his alleviators are working. Now, if you didn't know, these are the things, as you can see, moving on the wings. So them two are fine. Now he checks the elevators, which are them. Up the lane, get off the floor and then land, and then finally the rudder, which is working well. Then he checks the propellers, are they all working fine? They seem to be working fine, they sound fine. The landing gear is okay, and then he looks in his cockpit, everything is looking good, everything is on and working, the radars are working. There would actually be where my feet are. Two pedals, which will control how I use the rudders, but obviously they don't have that because this plane isn't too realistic. And if you can see where there's green, about here, that is what will show, like if the landing gear is up or down. So he will keep an eye on that when taking off. So now the pilot would make sure this runway is clear, right, and then left. Make sure no planes are landing or taking off, and then they will follow this yellow line on the floor, which is a taxiing line. And we'll try and line the plane up as perfectly as possible with the lines in the middle of the runway. And I didn't do too good of a job with that. Then I'm not going to say this shit because it would just be weird. But look, I'm quite nice when you line it up. And then the pilot would check with ground control if clearance is permitted, if takeoff is permitted or cleared. And I'm going to set a waypoint for the runway that I'm going to be landing on, which is runway 21. So once he gets clearance to take off, he will slowly push down on the accelerator or the throttle. Still make sure no planes are going to be crossing the runway, and then pulling up when he reaches about 100 knots, which is about now. Then he stays directly above the runway until he gets over these poles, and now brings the landing gear up. Waits until he clears the airport and starts turning. And sorry about those lines actually gonna get annoying. 1 second. Alright, I don't know actually how to sort that. I think they're gone now. Yeah, they're gone. Alright, so yeah, now he's over the ocean, gonna be starting to climb up. I'm gonna put this in cinematic mode. Just starting to climb up, get some height. And the runway I'm gonna be landing on is around about there. So then, I'm not going to do anything too special, like I could do a barrel roll. Obviously that is not recommended in a plane like this, because it is a very fucking heavy plane, and it takes fucking ages, but I know I'm going to crash it, and I was so excited when I saw it, please don't crash it, please don't crash it. Right, I'm not doing another one of them, because I'm going to crash a plane, I like to plane. I need to pull up in height now. Now, a real pilot would not have done that, a real pilot would have died, or he would have fallen out of his seat and snapped his neck. So what we want to do is, for about this time, the pilot would be radioing through to Los Santos Tower, saying, can I have permission to land on runway 21? And if permission was granted, he would start beginning his lineup for a final approach, which means he's not going to be doing anything else until he lands. So what I want to do, I know that the runway is roughly over there. I can see it just out of the corner of that window. So what he would do is, if you can't see, I've got a little blue blip on my mini-map, so I know whereabouts it is roughly. I know where it is anyway. So he's going to start going into his turn now. And when he finishes that turn, and he's happy with his lineup for the runway, he will say Los Santos Tower. Then he'll say the name of the plane, like the code name for it, on final approach, like AN127 on final approach from the 21. Bring down his landing gear now. He'll be happy with this approach. Quiet high, good height, good speed. I'm slowly letting my hand off of the accelerator. And the bump thing, there's a plane down, there's a little bit of turbulence, and then the hand goes on the brake, pulling up the nose of the plane slightly. So the back wheels touch down first, and then the front wheels touch down shortly after. Now you'll know if it's a successful landing because the windows will not smash. As you can see, all of these windows are in perfect condition. Fuck off, Dom. I know what he'd do next is he would get off the runway, so he would come off here and he would say Los Santos Tower, say the code call sign for the plane, cleared from runway 21, taxiing to hangar for parking. Now when I say taxiing to hangar, I'm literally going to be going over here, using my rudders for this, following this yellow line on the floor of the taxiing lane, and parking it here. Now, I'm not going to go too far into this part of the taxiing lane because the wings have to fit a certain part of them. Here should do. And there we go. I know that wasn't a very exciting video. It was literally me flying the plane in first person, but I just wanted to see how well I could fly in GTA 5 because I've been really excited to fly a plane like this, and I finally found one spawned in at the airport. This wasn't exactly an exciting video. I know a lot of people would have clicked off this video by now. But I really, really like planes, and I've actually flown a plane before, as I've said, with an instructor. So this is actually the plane I want to fly when I'm in the RAF, because I'm joining the RAF. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you didn't, please make sure to leave a like. It'd be so much appreciated. Subscribe as well, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.